Welcome to Study with Sudhir, your digital classroom. I'm TS Sudhir. Today we are going to be looking at a story called The Umbrella Man by Roald Dahl, and that's part of the Telangana Intermediate English syllabus for the first year.
నా పేరు ఉమా సుధీర్. ఇవాళ మనం ది అంబ్రెలా మ్యాన్ బై రోల్డ్ డాల్ చూడబోతున్నాము. దానిలో కీ వర్డ్స్ మరి ఎంటైర్ స్టోరీ లైన్ నేను తెలుగులో చెప్తాను.
But before we start, I want to request you to subscribe to Study with Sudhir YouTube channel, because we really want to create a community of students, parents and teachers, so that all of us can actually grow together in the pursuit of education, and also spread the word and like and share this particular video. Hello friends, today we are going to be looking at this story called The Umbrella Man by Roald Dahl. Now, who is Roald Dahl? Because all of you will need to know a little bit about the author and also mention his previous works, because that kind of gives the examiner a sense that this particular student knows the previous works and is familiar with the work done by this particular author. So Roald Dahl was a popular children's author of the 20th century. He was born in Wales in the UK, and he initially worked as a salesman, but he also started writing stories for adults and also wrote poems. In fact, Television is a very popular poem written by Roald Dahl. But it was his stories for children that really made him very, very popular. His work, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, is the most widely read of his books. In fact, he's also written scripts for many movies.
Roald Dahl, an author, యూకేలో పుట్టారు. అంటే స్కాట్లాండ్, వేల్స్, ఇంగ్లాండ్ ఉంటుంది, దానిలో వేల్స్లో పుట్టారు. ఆయన పెద్దవాళ్ళకు కూడా రాశారు, పోయమ్స్ కూడా రాశారు, కానీ అన్నిటికన్నా ఎక్కువ పాపులారిటీ ఆయనకి చిల్డ్రన్ స్టోరీస్ రాయడంలో ఆయనకు దొరికింది. చాలా పాపులర్ ఆథర్ పిల్లలతోటి. ఆయన రాసిన చార్లీ అండ్ ద చాక్లెట్ ఫ్యాక్టరీ అన్నది పిల్లలు చాలా ఎంజాయ్ చేసి చదువుతారు. మీరు ఎప్పుడైనా మిస్ అయిపోయారు అంటే ఒకసారి వెళ్ళి అది కూడా చదవండి, ఎందుకంటే చాలా ఎంజాయ్ చేస్తారు. టెలివిజన్ అన్న ఒక పోయం కూడా, ఇప్పుడు ఇవాళ కూడా రిలెవెంట్గా ఉన్న ఒక పోయం, అది కూడా ఆయననే రాశారు.
Okay, so let's now talk about the story, Uma, because The Umbrella Man is a very interesting story. It's a story of a mother and her daughter and a person who comes with the umbrella. So what's really the mystery about this whole umbrella?
ఈ స్టోరీ ఒక 12-year-old గర్ల్ నరేట్ చేస్తున్నట్టు మనకు వస్తుంది. ఈ అమ్మాయి, 12-year-old గర్ల్ అండ్ హర్ మదర్ లండన్కి వెళ్తున్నారు ఒక డెంటిస్ట్ అపాయింట్మెంట్ కోసం. డెంటిస్ట్ అపాయింట్మెంట్ అయిన తర్వాత వాళ్ళు ఒక కెఫేకి వెళ్ళి అమ్మ కాఫీ తాగుతుంది, అమ్మాయి ఏమో బనానా స్ప్లిట్, అంటే అది ఒక ఐస్ క్రీమ్, లోపల ఐస్ క్రీమ్ ఉంటుంది, అరటిపండు లోపల ఐస్ క్రీమ్ పెట్టి అది తినేస్తుంది. తర్వాత బయటకు వచ్చేటప్పటికి ఆరు అవుతుంది టైము, అప్పటికి వర్షం పడబోతోంది. అప్పుడు వాళ్ళు సరే ట్యాక్సీ తీసుకుందాము, మన దగ్గర అంబ్రెల్లా కూడా లేదు కదా అని అట్లా ట్రై చేస్తున్నప్పుడు ట్యాక్సీలు ఏం దొరకవు, ఎందుకంటే దానిలో అన్ని ప్యాసింజర్స్ ఉంటూ ఉంటారు. అప్పుడు ఒక ఓల్డ్ మ్యాన్ వస్తారనమాట వాళ్ళ దగ్గరికి, వచ్చి మీరు కొంచెం నాకు హెల్ప్ చేయాలి అట్లా ఇట్లా అంటున్నప్పుడు వాళ్ళ మదర్కి చాలా సస్పిషియస్గా ఉంటుంది. ఏంటి ఈయన వచ్చి నన్ను డబ్బులు అడుగుతున్నాడా, ఎవరు ఈయన అన్నది ఒక సస్పిషన్ చాలా ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది వాళ్ళ మదర్ మైండ్లో. అప్పుడు స్లోగా ఆయన కాన్వర్సేషన్ స్టార్ట్ చేసి ఏమంటారంటే, ఆయన చేతిలో ఒక అంబ్రెల్లా కూడా ఉంటుంది, పెద్ద సిల్క్ అంబ్రెల్లా. ఆయన ఏమంటారంటే, నేను ఇంటి నుంచి వచ్చేటప్పుడు నా వాలెట్, వాలెట్ అంటే పర్స్, అది తేవడం మర్చిపోయాను, ఈ వర్షంలో నేను నా కాళ్ళంతా నొప్పేస్తున్నాయి కాబట్టి నేను ఇంటికి వెళ్ళిపోవాలి, ఒక టాక్సీ తీసుకోవాలంటే ఒక్క పౌండ్, పౌండ్ అన్నది అక్కడ ఉన్న కరెన్సీ అనమాట, మనకి ఎట్లా రూపీ ఉంటుందో వాళ్ళకి పౌండ్, ఆ ఒక్క పౌండ్ ఉంటే నేను ఇంటికి వెళ్ళిపోతాను అంటారు. వాళ్ళ అమ్మ కొంచెం సస్పీషియస్గానే ఆయనని క్వశ్చన్ చేస్తూ ఉన్నప్పుడు ఆయన అంటాడు, నేను కానీ ఫ్రీగా తీసుకుని మీ దగ్గర ఈ అంబ్రెల్లా, మీకు నేను 20 pounds తీసుకున్నాను కాబట్టి ఈ అంబ్రెల్లా మీకు ఇస్తాను, ఆ అంబ్రెల్లా తీసుకొని మీరు నాకు 1 pound ఇవ్వండి అంటాడు. వాళ్ళ అమ్మ చూస్తుంది అంబ్రెల్లా కూడా చాలా బ్యూటిఫుల్గా ఉంది కదా అని. కానీ ఈ అమ్మాయి 12-year-old అమ్మాయి ఏమంటుందంటే, ఇంత మంచి అయినా పాపం, ఇంత ముసలైనా మమ్మల్ని అడుగుతున్నారు కదా, అమ్మ ఏంటి అంబ్రెల్లా తీసుకొని ఇట్లా చేయడం ఆయనని ఎక్స్ప్లాయిట్ చేసినట్టు అవుతుంది కదా, ఆయనని అడ్వాంటేజ్ తీసుకున్నట్టు అవుతున్నది కదా అని ఇట్లా చూస్తుంది. వాళ్ళ అమ్మ కూడా ఓకే అని మనం చూసి ఆయనను చూసేసి మళ్ళీ అంటది, కాదు కాదు మీ అంబ్రెల్లా తీసుకోవడం నాకు కరెక్ట్ అనిపించట్లేదు, నేను ఓన్లీ మీకు ఒక పౌండ్ ఇస్తాను మీరు వెళ్ళిపోండి అంటారు. అప్పుడు ఆయన అంటారు, నో నో నో, నాట్ ఎట్ ఆల్ పాసిబుల్, అట్లా ఉండదు, నేను అంబ్రెల్లా ఇస్తాను మీరు నాకు 1 pound ఇవ్వండి అంటే, వాళ్ళ అమ్మకు అప్పుడు కాన్షియన్స్ కూడా కొంచెం క్లియర్ అయిపోతుంది, ఓకే అని అంబ్రెల్లా తీసుకొని ఆయనకి 1 pound ఇస్తుంది. అప్పుడు మా అమ్మాయికి చెప్తుంది అనమాట, ఎట్లు ఎప్పుడు మనం చాలా కేర్ఫుల్గా ఉండాలి, ఎవరు వాళ్ళు అని మనం బాగా అసెస్ చేసే చేయాలి, లేకపోతే చాలామంది మనని ట్రిక్ చేస్తూ ఉంటారు, మనని ఫూల్ చేస్తూ ఉంటారు అట్లా అంటుంది. ఆ లెక్చర్ ఇచ్చేటప్పుడు ఈ అమ్మాయి చూస్తుంది ఆయన టాక్సీ కోసం నిలబడట్లేదు, ఎక్కడో అట్లా 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 పరిగెత్తి వెళ్ళిపోతున్నాడని. అంటది దట్ ఎల్డర్లీ మ్యాన్ ఎక్కడో వెళ్ళిపోతున్నారు కదా అంటే, వాళ్ళ అమ్మ కూడా డౌట్ వస్తుంది, నాకేమో కాళ్ళు నొప్పి అసలు నడవలేకపోతున్నాను అని అన్నాడు కదా, సడన్గా వెళ్ళిపోతున్నారు కదా అని. సరే అని వీళ్ళు కూడా అంబ్రెల్లా పెట్టుకొని హ్యాపీగా ఉంటారు, కానీ సరే ఈయన ఎక్కడ వెళ్తున్నారు అని ఫాలో చేస్తారు. ఆయన ఇట్లా 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 తిప్పుతారు బాగా, ఆయనకు తెలియదు వీళ్ళు వెనకాల వస్తున్నారని. లాస్ట్కి వెళ్తే ఒక పబ్, పబ్ అంటే ఏంటి అక్కడ విస్కీ బియర్ అట్లాంటివి ఉంటాయి కదా, అట్లాంటి చోట ఆయన లోపల వెళ్తారు. వీళ్ళు బయట నుంచి విండో నుంచి చూస్తూ ఉంటారనమాట, ఏం చేస్తున్నారు ఆయన అసలు అని. అక్కడ ఇంగ్లాండ్లో కోటు హ్యాట్ అది అట్లా వేసుకుంటారు, ఇట్లాంటి వెదర్లో ఇంకా కూడా వేసుకుంటారు. ఆ కోటు హ్యాట్ ఒక చోట పెట్టేసి ఆయన బార్ దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళి అక్కడ వీళ్ళకి వినిపించదు కానీ ఈయన లిప్ మూమెంట్ తోటి తెలుస్తుంది అనమాట. ఆ బార్ మ్యాన్ వెళ్ళి ఒక గ్లాస్లో ఇట్లా ఒక బ్రౌన్ కలర్ లిక్విడ్ తీసి ఈయనకు పెడతాడు. ఈయన ఒకే దానిలో తాగేస్తాడు, సంతోషంగా ఉంటాడు ఈ ఓల్డ్ మ్యాన్. అప్పుడు అమ్మాయి అనుకుంటుంది ట్యాక్సీలో వెళ్ళాలని చెప్పారు కానీ ఇప్పుడేమో ఏం చేస్తున్నాడు ఆ డబ్బులతోటి, ఆ 1 pound తోటి ఆయన విస్కీ కొనుక్కున్నాడు అని తెలిసిపోతుంది వీళ్ళకు. అప్పుడు ఏం చేయబోతున్నాడు, ఇంత మ్యాడ్ మ్యానా, మనకి 20 pound అంబ్రెల్లా ఇచ్చేసి 1 pound ఆయన తాగుతాడా అని మళ్ళీ ఆయన టక్ 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 అని మళ్ళీ బయటకు వస్తూ ఉంటారు. హ్యాట్ వేసుకొని కోట్ వేసుకొని అక్కడ చాలా అంబ్రెల్లాస్ ఉంటాయన్నమాట, వర్షాకాలం కదా, అక్కడ ఒక అంబ్రెల్లా కూల్గా తీసుకొని బయటకు మళ్ళీ వస్తాడు. వీళ్ళు మళ్ళీ ఫాలో అవుతారు, అట్లా హైడ్ చేసుకొని ఫాలో అవుతే ఆయన మళ్ళీ వేరే వైపు వెళ్ళి అక్కడ వెళ్ళి ఇంకో ఆయనకి ఇట్లాగే 1 pound అమ్మేసి మళ్ళీ ఈ బార్కే రాడు, ఇంకో బార్కి వెళ్తూ ఉంటాడు. అప్పుడు అమ్మకు అర్థమవుతుంది అనమాట, ఈయన మళ్ళీ ట్రిక్ చేశాడు, ఎవరిదో అంబ్రెల్లా తీసుకొని మన దగ్గర 20 pound అట్లా అని చెప్పేసి మన దగ్గర 1 pound తీసుకొని. అంటే సారాంశం ఏంటంటే ఎక్కడైనా మిమ్మల్ని ట్రిక్ చేయొచ్చు అన్నది, పొలైట్గా ఉండొచ్చు, చాలా స్వీట్గా మాట్లాడొచ్చు కానీ మీరు ట్రిక్ అయిపోతారు ఒక్కొక్కసారి అన్నది సారాంశం.
సో ది ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ పార్ట్ ఇస్ దట్ దేర్ ఇస్ అ ట్విస్ట్ అట్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టోరీ. సో ది ఆథర్ హ్యాస్ మేడ్ యూ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద స్టోరీ, రిమైన్ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద స్టోరీ టిల్ ద వెరీ ఎండ్. This other interesting thing is that the title of the story is called The Umbrella Man, but the interesting and the ironic part is that the umbrella does not belong to the man, you know. So it's interesting that he's called it The Umbrella Man. So I'm going to go through the story, the important portions of the story. Sometimes it also can come as an excerpt and then questions can be asked from depending on the excerpt for the story. So I'll go through the important stories and we will also mark the keywords. So please keep the book with you. Also have a pencil and a pen and a notebook in which you can write down the key points and also underline the keywords. Adi chala important. Ipudu I am going to tell you about a funny thing that happened to my mother and me yesterday evening. So the girl is telling the story in first person and she's telling you a story which happened yesterday evening. So very immediacy is there.
అప్పుడే జరిగినట్టు అనమాట మనకి, నిన్న జరిగిన విషయం అండి నేను మీకు చెప్తున్నాను అంటే చాలా కాన్వర్సేషనల్ టోన్. ఇది చిల్డ్రన్ స్టోరీ కదా అందుకని ఆయన స్టైల్ కూడా చాలా సింపుల్ గా ఉంటుంది, కాన్వర్సేషనల్ గా ఉంటుంది.
అండ్ షీస్ టెలింగ్ యూ రైట్ ఎట్ ద బిగినింగ్ సో దట్ షీస్ ప్రిపేరింగ్ యూ ఫర్ వాట్ ద స్టోరీ ఇస్ బికాస్ షీ సేస్ ఇట్స్ అ ఫనీ థింగ్. About a funny thing that happened to my mother and me. So she sees it as a funny thing irrespective of what happened later on, because they do feel that they were cheated in a sense, though they got a good umbrella in return. But the little girl is actually finding the whole episode very funny. I am 12 years old and I am a girl. My mother is 34, but I am nearly as tall as she already. So she's giving a lot of detail, the age, how they look, how she is in terms of height as her mother. Yesterday afternoon, my mother took me to London to see the dentist. He found one hole. It was in the back tooth and he filled it without hurting me too much. So you see the amount of detail that Roald Dahl is giving as part of a children's story.
అంటే పళ్ళకి రిపేర్ చేసుకొని వచ్చాను, నాకేం నొప్పేం పడలేదు. తర్వాత ఐస్ క్రీమ్ కూడా దాని రీజన్ ఉండొచ్చు, ఎందుకంటే ఎప్పుడు ఆఫ్టర్ టూత్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డెంటిస్ట్రీ దే ఆస్క్ యూ టు ఈట్ సంథింగ్ కోల్డ్, అందుకనే బనానా స్ప్లిట్ ఐస్ క్రీమ్ తింటదమ్మా.
ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ వి వెంట్ టు ఎ కాఫీ, ఐ హాడ్ ఎ బనానా స్ప్లిట్ అండ్ మై మదర్ హాడ్ ఎ కప్ ఆఫ్ కాఫీ. By the time we got up to leave, it was about 6 o'clock. Okay. When we came out of the cafe, it had started to rain. So they're creating the setting for the umbrella. We must get a taxi, my mother said. We were wearing ordinary hats and coats and it was raining quite hard.
Ante raincoat laga kaadu, manamu normal weather ketla esukuntamo atlanti dress esukunnaru, andukante veellaku umbrella kavali anna oka necessity in cheppadan kosam.
It also kind of conveys what kind of social background they come from, because the mother says, I wish we had a car with a chauffeur. Chauffeur ante driver. That, you know, we had
luxury cars lo usually chauffeur antaru, driver anakunda chauffeur antaru, dani spelling kuda meer chusukondi.
Yeah. And just then a man came up to us. He was a small man and he was pretty old, probably 70 or more. So 12 year old, 34 year old, and he's double the mother's age, about 70 years old. So look at the amount of detailing that Roald Dahl has given in this story.
Ante manaku oka sympathy kuda raavadan kosam, chala elderly man,
and he was also small in height. He raised his hat politely. That's a very British way of kind of showing respect, when you take off the hat and kind of bend it head a little, and said to my mother, excuse me, I do hope you will excuse me. He had a fine white mustache and bushy white eyebrows and a wrinkly pink face. Detail please underline these keywords: white mustache, bushy white eyebrows, and a wrinkly pig face. Please remember this great description that Roald Dahl has given. He was sheltering under an umbrella which he held high over his head. So please remember these details. Now, then he asked them for a favor.
In this line where it says, yes, my mother said, very cool and distant. Ante chala friendly ga ledu. Amma emo, okay, chepandi meeru. Annattu atla adigaru anamata.
So then the daughter says, I saw my mother looking at him suspiciously. Suspiciously is a key word, please underline it. She's a suspicious person. This is what her daughter also thinks. My mother, she's especially suspicious of two things: strange men and boiled eggs.
అంటే ఒక ఫన్నీ ఒక డిస్క్రిప్షన్ అనమాట. బాయిల్డ్ ఎగ్స్కి ఎందుకు ఫన్నీ ఇదిగా ఉంటారంటే, దాని అంటుంది బాయిల్ ఎగ్ అయిన తర్వాత దాన్ని కట్ చేసేసి లోపల ఎట్లా ఎట్లా స్పూన్ తోటి చూస్తుందట, లోపల నుంచి ఎలుక ఏమైనా వస్తుందేమో అని. అది అందుకని అట్లా చూస్తుంది. జస్ట్ టు సెట్ అ ఫన్నీ టోన్ ఆర్ అ హ్యూమరస్ టోన్ టు దిస్, లైట్ హ్యూమరస్ టోన్.
అండ్ విత్ స్ట్రేంజ్ మెన్ షీ హాస్ ఎ గోల్డెన్ రూల్ విచ్ సేస్ ద నైసర్ ద మ్యాన్ సీమ్స్ టు బి ద మోర్ సస్పీషియస్ యూ మస్ట్ బికమ్. So any man you don't know, she says, if they are being very nice to you, you actually must be more suspicious.
Ade mi amma father kuda cheptu undochu, evaraina chaala manchiga mi toti pravartisthe meer koncham jagrataga undandi, enduku vaallu atla untunnaru annadi aalochinchalani cheptaru meek safety cheppetappudu kuda.
So this old man was particularly nice. He was polite, he was well spoken, he was well dressed, he was a real gentleman. And the reason I knew he was a gentleman was because of his shoes. So just see the amount of detail: mustache, the color of his face, even the eyebrows that he has, you know, the amount of, and it also shows that this girl is very
observant,
sharp in very observation, you know, in her observation she is very sharp. So she says, because of his shoes I knew he was a gentleman. You can always spot a gentleman by the shoes he wears was one of my mother's favorite sayings. This man had beautiful brown shoes.
And this also me shows that 12-year-old child who is very influenced by the mother in outlook, in deciding who is a good person, who is a bad person, and how do you judge that? That usually happens kada. Pillalu vaalla amma etla nerpiste atla koncham vaalla mana psychology kuda atlage untund annata.
The truth of the matter is, the little man was saying, I have got myself into a bit of a scrape. Scrape as in a bit of a
trouble.
I need some help, not much I assure you. It's actually nothing, but I do need it. You see, madam, old people like me can become terribly forgetful. So he's kind of building up the base for what he's going to say. My mother's chin was up and she was staring down at him along the full length of her nose. So it's almost like a long nose she has, and she was staring at him, still looking very suspiciously and not in a very friendly manner.
Danlo oka word use chesaru, frosty nosed stare of my mother. Frosty ante neellemo ice ayinappudu frost antaru danni. Frost ante chala cold idiga, ante warm ga lekunda. Warm anedi friendly anamata, cold ante chala distant ga undadam.
So it was a fearsome thing, this frosty nosed stare as in looking at very somebody
without blinking
your eyes, of my mother. Most people go to pieces completely when she gives it to them, you know. Most people don't particularly feel very comfortable, they're actually a little scared when she actually looks at them.
Go to pieces ante vallu asalu vaalla stability ko
feel rattled, yeah,
vallu rattled aipotharu anamata.
I once saw my own headmistress began to stammer and simper like an idiot when my mother gave her a really foul, frosty noser. You know, that her own headmistress of her school itself began to stammer. You know, when you feel afraid, feel scared, your sentences don't form very easily. You know, that kind of a thing. The headmistress began to stammer. So the girl also has a good memory. She remembers that particular incident from what she said. He gave a gentle smile, but the little man on the pavement with the umbrella over his head did not bat an eyelid. He gave a gentle smile. I said, I beg you to believe, madam, that I am not in the business of stopping ladies in the street and telling them my trouble. So he is trying to
convince them
that I am a good man.
Usually cheyanamma naaku ivvala itla porapata ayipoyindi, first time nenu itla marchipothunnanu kabatti meer koncham help cheyalani cheptunnaru.
Then I felt quite embarrassed by my mother's, the mother is still sharp. She says, I should hope not, you know. She's a I hope that's the case. So I felt quite embarrassed by my mother's sharpness. I wanted to say to her, oh mummy, for heaven's sake, He's a very old man and sweet and polite and he's some sort of trouble. So don't be beastly to him. So beastly. Beastly is like an animal, you know. So she feels that her mother is almost having the aggression of an animal. So she wants to tell her mother that, you know, calm down. Don't be like that kind of a behavior with this old man.
He seems such a nice man. Yeah. And usually avutadi kada. పిల్లలు అమ్మ కరెక్ట్గా బిహేవ్ చేయట్లేదు, మా స్కూల్లో వచ్చినప్పుడు చాలా షార్ప్గా మాట్లాడుతున్నారు మా ఫ్రెండ్స్ తోటి, అట్లా ఒక ఫీలింగ్ ఉంటుంది. సిమిలర్లీ ఇట్స్ ఎ 12-year-old అనమాట. సో షీఈస్ టెల్లింగ్ హర్ షీఈస్ లుకింగ్ అట్ హర్ మదర్ అండ్ సే ఇంత రూడ్గా అవసరమా.
సో The little man shifted his umbrella from one hand to the other. I have never forgotten it before. So he's now trying to say that he has forgotten that wallet at home. So he's not having the money to hire a taxi and go back home when it is already raining very hard. So he says, my wallet, I must have left it in my other jacket. Again, the mother, the word uses sternly. Please underline it. So she's still cold, frosty. So if you have to use the words for a mother, frosty, nosed, cold, sternly, that's the kind of adjectives which have been used for the mother. I must have left it in my other jacket. Isn't it the silliest thing to do? Are you asking me to give you money? The mother asked. Said, oh, good gracious me, not. Heaven forbid I should never do that. Then what are you asking? My mother said, do hurry up. We are getting scopers in. So the mother is very impatient. You know, she's not very friendly. She's not having the time to kind of listen to this man's story. So she says, hurry up because we are getting drenched in the rain.
అక్కడ ఒక వర్డ్ యూజ్ చేశారు, సోక్ టు ద స్కిన్ అంటే చాలా తడిచిపోతున్నాము అన్నది అర్థం అక్కడ.
I know you are and that's why I'm offering you the umbrella of mine to protect you and to keep forever if only what? If only you would give me in return a pound for my taxi fare just to get me home. So now he says, I know you're getting drenched, so that's why I'm offering you this umbrella to keep it with yourself forever. If in return, if you can give me £1 so that I can use that to hire a taxi and go back home. My mother was still suspicious. See, the word suspicious has been used continuously by the daughter for the mother. If you had no money in the first place, and how did you get here? She's asking him questions now. She's cross-questioning him. I walked. Every day I go for a lovely long walk and then I summon a taxi to get me home. I do it every day of the year. So he has his answers ready. She's asking him the right questions, but he also has his answers ready because as we realize later, he's a seasoned liar. So he says, every day I walk, I come here and then I summon a taxi in order to go back home. So why don't you walk home now? My mother said. Oh, I wish I could. I do wish I could, but I don't think I could manage this on this silly old legs of mine. I've gone too far already.
చాలా నడిచాను కాబట్టి నేను నడవలేను అని ఆయన చెప్పేస్తున్నారు అనమాట. తను ఆలోచిస్తుంది, ఈయన కరెక్టే చెప్తున్నాడు. చూయింగ్ హర్ లోవర్ లిప్ అంటే థింకింగ్ అనమాట.
షీఈస్ బిగినింగ్ టు మెల్ట్ ఎ లిటిల్. మెల్ట్ ఎ లిటిల్ మీన్స్ షీఈస్ బిగినింగ్ టు ఫీల్ ఎ లిటిల్ సింపథెటిక్. కొంచెం సింపతి అయింది. సో షీఈస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ థింకింగ్ దట్ ఓకే, మేబీ ఈస్ టెలింగ్ ద రైట్ స్టోరీ. అండ్ ద ఐడియా and the second reason is two reasons. One, she's feeling a little sympathetic because of all the story, then the image of the old man, and third, the idea of getting an umbrella to shelter under must have tempted her a good deal. She also, because umbrella is good quality, for £1 to get that umbrella,
he also sells that to her. He says it's lovely, it's of silk and it cost me £20, and he says that I'd rather give my umbrella and get home very quickly because that's not what I want. And that's when the mother goes for the purse anamata. She goes for the purse, clasp of for a purse antunaru ante
holding it tight.
Adi daniki oka buckle untundi kada, dan degariki potundi buckle open cheyadanikosam. She saw me watching her, ante nenu ippudu itla chustunnan maa ammani stern ga, enduku inta aina cheptunappudu meer advantage teeskuntunara annadi next paragraph lo ostunnan anamata.
So again, now it's a daughter who is giving her one of my own frosty nose looks. So this frosty nose is a phrase which has been used quite often by Roald Dahl in this particular story.
Disapproval anamata.
Yeah, it conveys disapproval that you do not like what is being done. Earlier by the mother and now by the daughter. So now listen, mummy, I was telling her, you simply must not take advantage of tired old men in this way. It is a rotten thing to do. Rotten.
She is not saying all this. ఇది మనకి ఎక్స్‌ప్లెయిన్ చేస్తున్నారు ఆ లుక్ లో ఏముంది అన్నది.
Yeah, and it is a rotten thing. Rotten is a very strong word. Rotten is something which is decayed, which is spoiled, and she thinks
it's a very bad thing to do.
It's a very bad thing and a negative thing to do. My mother paused and looked back at me. Then she said to the old man, I don't think it's quite right that I should take an umbrella from you worth £20. So the cost of the umbrella is £20 and in return she has to give just £1. So in that sense, she thinks, okay, she's tempted by the whole idea. But she says, no, I don't think it's a good idea. I would much rather give you just a taxi fare and be done with it. You know, I'll just give you that £1. No, 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 it's out of the question. I would not dream of it. Not in 1 million years. I would never accept money from you like that. Take the umbrella, dear lady, and keep the rain off your shoulders. Because the man is actually looking for that £1. So he is saying, I will never take that £1 from you and not give you the umbrella. So you need that umbrella and I will give it to you.
And he is saying that I am a very good man, very honest man, and I won't take money just like that from you.
So the mother now gives the daughter a triumphant sideways look. So she is looking at her in a very triumphant. See, he is the one who is giving me an umbrella, not me. I am not trying to take it from her. I am not trying to cheat him. I am not trying to take advantage. He is the one who wants to give me the umbrella. So it's the triumphant sideways kind of a look. And he took it. She fished. So there you are. She was telling me, you are wrong. He wants me to have it. She fished into her purse and took out a pound note. She held it to the little man. He took it and handed her the umbrella. He pocketed the pound, raised his hat again, gave a quick bow and thank you, madam. Thank you. And he was gone.
Fished and a word again. Chala saman unnapudu oka chinnadi teyadaniki fishing antaru.
Yeah. Come under me. Keep dry, darling, my mother said. Aren't we lucky? I never had a silk umbrella before.
She's pleased now.
So she's pleased, and also it shows that, you know, they're kind of middle class. They never had a silk umbrella, which is something which is associated more with rich people. I couldn't afford it, she says. So it kind of gives you a sense of the economic status of this particular family, the mother and daughter, not very well off. So why were you so horrid to him in the beginning? She still says, in the beginning, she was, that her mother was not very friendly and not, you know, not making the person comfortable. I wanted to satisfy myself that he was not a trickster. You know, trickster as in a fraud, you know, somebody who's out to cheat. And I did. He was a gentleman and I'm very pleased, I'm very tired. So she thinks that she has got a good deal, that she has not been cheated. But later on, we realize that she's the one who has been cheated
but
in a different way.
But she changed her mind about this old man and matter. First, chala suspicious ga undi. Ippudemo chala mancha ayina actually. Chala gentleman. Aina titled gentleman ga kuda undachu antadi. Titled ante akkada knights atla okoka sir anadanta istaru. Titles koncham noble people ki, koncham manchi class of people ki. Atla unna gentleman ante tana abhiprayam full change ayipoyindi.
Yeah. And a real gentleman, she went on, wealthy too, otherwise he wouldn't have had a silk umbrella. I wouldn't be surprised if he's a titled person, Sir Harry Goldsworthy or something like that. Yes, mummy, this will be a very good lesson to you. Never rush things, always take your time when you are summing someone up. So she's giving advice, which is very ironic. Okay, as we will learn later, that she's giving advice to her daughter that you should always behave in such a way, you should not kind of immediately come to conclusions, you should ask the right questions and then take your decisions. Then the daughter says, there he goes, see, kind of the way. She says, he's crossing the street. Goodness, mummy, what a hurry he's in. You know, so, because earlier he had said, old legs, he can't walk and all that. But look at the hurry with which he's walking. He's walking so fast.
Tired ga unnan ani chepparu. Ippudu emo chala almost parigette laaga hurry ga ellipothunnaru.
Next paragraph lo, there is a particular phrase, dodge nimbly in and out of the traffic. Dodge as in, you know, when you're with a lot of traffic and you're dodging the traffic cars and you're just running fast.
Avoiding any obstruction but moving very fast. Adan mata, nimbly ante.
And nimbly ante, it's also quick footed. You know, you're kind of moving very fast. He doesn't look very tired to me. So they are looking at him and they are kind of this thing. He doesn't look very tired to me.
Why did he say that?
So then they decide that what to do. Should we take a taxi and go back home or should we follow the old man? Because she's not feeling very happy about what has happened. Because just 1 minute before, she has given him a good certificate that he could be a titled person. You know, Sir Harry Goldsworthy or some name like that. So she sees him in a terrific hurry, that he was bustling along the pavement and a footpath, sidestepping the other pedestrians and swinging his arms like a soldier on the march. You know, like this, he's walking very, very fast, you know, almost with a sense
of
purpose,
energy.
With a lot of energy and with a sense of purpose that he wants to do something immediately. He's up to something, my mother said, stony faced. So frosty nosed and now stony faced. Stony faced ante
no expression.
You know, no expression and looking not happy, not pleased, a bit
she
of anger.
She wants to find out what happened.
And so then she says, but I'm going to find out. So she also kind of takes her daughter's arm and follows him. So then they are kind of following him and we came to the corner and turned right. The little man was about 20 yards ahead of us. So he's not very far off. He was scuttling along like a rabbit. A rabbit is an animal which
small
kind of
steps and jumps very fast.
Jumps very fast. So, you know, it shows a particular speed of that old man. And we had to walk very fast to keep up with him. The rain was pelting down harder than ever now, and I could see dripping from the brim of his hat onto his shoulder. So they could see that it's raining very hard from his hat. It's kind of dripping on his shoulders. But we were snug and dry under our lovely big silk umbrella. So because of his umbrella, they were actually dry and snug. Snug means again, you know, comfortable. Sense of comfort. So then they say, I don't care. Then the daughter says, what if he turns around and sees us following him? The mother says, I don't care what he thinks. You know, so the mother is not very kind of bothered about, you know, what others will think. She wants to do what she thinks is right. He lied to us. He said he was too tired to walk any further, and he's practically running us off our feet. He's a barefaced liar. Barefaced ante with a straight face. With a straight face lying. That is called barefaced. He's a crook.
Crook ante vedava.
Yeah. You mean he's not a titled gentleman? So now she kind of confronts, you know, earlier you said he could be a Sir Harry Goldsworth or something. So you are now saying that he's not a titled gentleman. And the earlier phrase, running us off our feet, is, you know, running faster than us. My mother is not happy with that question. She says, be quiet. At the next crossing, the little man turned right again. Then he turned left, then right, you know. I am not giving up now. My mother said, he has disappeared. I cried, where has he gone now? He went in that door. I saw him into that house. Good heavens, it's a pub. You know, pub, as we explained earlier, is a place where you can have liquor. It was a pub. In big letters right across the front, it said the Red Lion. You know, one of the questions that could be asked is that, you know, what is the name of the pub where the old man disappeared? It's called the Red Lion. And it was written in big capital letters. You're not going in, are you, mummy? The daughter is not very happy with whatever is happening. No, we'll not go into the pub. We'll watch it from outside.
And also, youngsters don't go into pubs. Yeah. I mean, she's a minor girl.
Yeah. Right? So there was a big plate glass window along the front of the pub, and although it was a bit steamy on the inside, so they could see from outside. So what did they see outside? They identified the person out there, and they saw that it was full of people, a lot of cigarette smoke, and the little old man was there right in the middle. He had removed his coat, he had removed his hat, and he was going towards the bar counter, the barman, and he placed both his hands and spoke to him, and they were trying to read his lip movements as to what he is doing. And then they saw that a small glass was brought with a brown color liquid, which was obviously alcohol. And he placed that £1 note, which the mother had given, on the counter as payment. That's my pound, the mother hissed. Hissed as in slightly that snake is the...
And an angry snake chases sound pair hissed.
Kind of a thing. That's my pound. It's almost like a whispering. By golly, he's got a nerve. He's got a nerve means he's rather, you know, how
cheeky. Daring.
He's how cheeky of him, you know, how daring of him to do something like this. What's in the glass, I asked. You know, obviously a 12-year-old girl doesn't know. She says, whiskey, my mother said, neat whiskey. That is, you know, without mixing any water. But the barman did not give him any change from the pond. That must be a treble whiskey, my mother said. What's a treble? 3 times in normal measure. That is, a treble whiskey is that, you know, when you kind of get
three triple times. Triple and treble are both interchangeable words.
And here, obviously, it means that, you know, he didn't give any change. Means that the entire glass cost £1. And the little man picked up the glass and put it to his lips. He tilted it gently, then he tilted it higher, and he drank it till the last drop. And in one shot, he finished off the entire drink. That's a jolly expensive drink. Jolly is, that's a very expensive drink. It's ridiculous. Fancy paying a pound for something to swallow in one go. So the mother is simply not approving. She doesn't like it at all for two reasons. One, to pay a pound for something to swallow in one go. And the second and the more important reason, that he has cheated her, and he has paid that £1 that he took from her in order to pay for the thing. So for two reasons, she's angry with that old man.
But the daughter will say, it's not for £1. In fact, he has paid £20, isn't it? He gave us also an umbrella.
Yeah. Hmm. Oh, so it did. He must be mad. So the mother thinks, yeah, oh yeah, of course, he gave us a £20 umbrella. So he must be mad, you know, crazy. The little man was standing by the bar with an empty glass in his hand. He was smiling now, and a sort of a golden glow of pleasure. Golden glow means he's looking very happy and, you know, glowing.
After having a drink.
Was spreading over his round pink face. I saw his tongue come out to lick the white mustache as though searching for that one last drop of that precious whiskey. So he's obviously someone
enjoying
enjoying his drink. Slowly, he turned away from the bar. And now the mother and the daughter see that he turns away from the bar and edges his way back through the crowd to where his hat and coat were hanging. Because usually at the entrance to the bar, because especially when it's raining, you don't like to go with wet clothes. So you take out the coat, you take out the hat, and you put it at the entrance to the umbrella.
That is usually the practice in many Western countries. In restaurants. You take off your hat and your coat outside and then walk inside with your normal clothes.
He put on his hat, he put on his coat at the entrance. Then in a manner so superbly cool, you know, now you see the superbly cool and casual that you hardly noticed at all, he lifted from the coat rack one of the many wet umbrellas hanging there and off he went.
అంటే తను చాలా కూల్ గా అక్కడ నుంచి ఇంకొక అంబ్రెల్లా వెట్ అంబ్రెల్లా అని తీసుకొని అట్లా వెళ్ళిపోతున్నారు అన్నమాట అంటే
చాలా as though it belonged to him you know, without raising any, arousing any suspicion. You know, nobody should get suspicious that he's walking away with someone else's umbrella.
Do you see that? My mother shrieked.
Did you see what he did?
అంటే వేరెవరిదో అంబ్రెల్లా ఇట్లా ఎత్తుకొని వెళ్ళిపోతున్నాడు అన్నది వాళ్ళ మదర్ కి చాలా షాక్ అన్నమాట.
So she says, he's coming out. So we lowered our umbrella to hide our faces and out from under it. Out he came, but he never looked in our direction. He opened his new umbrella over his head and scurried off down the road the way he had come. So that's his little game, that he steals the umbrella from the rack, goes and gives it to somebody for £1 to come here and drinking all over again. Neat, I said, super. So the little girl is almost appreciative of
the con game,
the cheating that the old man does. We followed him back to the main street from where he had first met him. We watched him as he proceeded with no trouble at all to exchange the new umbrella for another pound note. This time it was with a tall, thin fellow who did not even have a coat or hat. As soon as the transaction was completed, our little man trotted off down the street and was lost in the crowd. This time he went in an opposite direction to another pound.
He's an expert. He's doing it cool.
And not at the same place.
He's not going to the same place. So he doesn't want to be caught.
So you see how clever he is. He never goes to the same pub twice. He could be doing this all night. Yes, my mother said. Of course. But I'll bet he prays like mad for rainy days. But he can do this cheating only on rainy days. You know, it has to rain for him. For him to do this, steel umbrellas, silk umbrellas, to do this game. So that's the nice little twist that Roald Dahl has brought at the end of the story. So the
surprise element to kopam em raledu valaku ayyo itla cheat ayipoyam kada ani oka, that's why she called it first itself a funny story. They are so, not saying yeah. that we were so angry with what happened, but they just thought, oh my god, you're so smart about the way he did it, though didn't approve of it.
Yeah, they didn't approve of it, so they lost the $1, but they got a $20 nice silk umbrella in return. But at the end of the story, it was also a case where, you know, they had been taken for a ride. They had actually fallen for the old man's story, in the sense that, you know, whatever he said, they believed it initially after feeling a little suspicious. So what you need to do is to, we will be looking at the questions in another video. We'll be doing all the stories questions, but a couple of quick points. You need to know the description of the three people, the daughter, the mother and the old man, in great detail. Mark all the keywords, include it in the answers whenever you are asked a question in the examination paper. Two, you also need to know the entire theme, what we discussed about the theme of cheating and the theme of, you know, trickery, you know, of the old man in a sense being a little clever and doing this little trick in order to ensure that he has his drink every day and especially on every rainy day.
యా సో మనము పారాగ్రాఫ్స్ బాగా జ్ఞాపకం పెట్టుకుంటే యూజువలీ ఎట్లా వస్తుందంటే ఆ పారాగ్రాఫ్లో వచ్చి మిమ్మల్ని డిస్క్రిప్షన్ అడగొచ్చు. వన్, అది జ్ఞాపకం పెట్టుకోవాలి. ఎవరు వీళ్ళు, ఎక్కడ వచ్చారు, ఎందుకు వచ్చారు, ఆయనని ఎట్లా కలిశారు, అవన్నీ మీరు జ్ఞాపకం పెట్టుకోవాలి. సింపుల్ సెంటెన్సెస్లో రాస్తే కూడా సరిపోతుంది. అండ్ కాంటెక్స్ట్, మీకు స్టోరీ చదివేశారనుకోండి, ఇప్పుడు విన్నారు కాబట్టి మీకు గుర్తుంటుంది ఇట్లా జరిగింది, ఇట్లా జరిగింది అన్నది. అది సింపుల్ సెంటెన్సెస్లో రాసుకోవడం. మనం ఇంకొక వీడియోలో ఇట్లా క్వశ్చన్స్ ఇట్లా వస్తున్నప్పుడు మనం ఎట్లా ఆన్సర్ చేయాలి అన్నది కూడా చూస్తాం.
ఓకే, సో ఐ హోప్ యు హావ్ ఎంజాయ్డ్ ది స్టోరీ, దట్స్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఐ హోప్ యు హావ్ ఆల్సో అండర్స్టుడ్ ది స్టోరీ వెరీ వెల్. And we will be dealing with the questions in a separate video. Thank you very much for watching.
Thank you.